Recording.
I've start by recording and share screen. Advance. Yes. Okay. All right. So let's get started.
Okay.
So you guys can see my screen, right?
Yeah, we can.
Okay.
Yes, you can see your screen.
So right now, where did we stop? We stopped at Navbar, right?
Yes.
This was where we stopped. We stopped at Navbar. So this was where the Navbar ended. So today we are going to work on this section. I've told you guys, if you want to join the class, go to a place that is less noisy. Your background noise is disturbing me. So this is it. We want to work on this other guy now. So before we left yesterday, somebody suggested that this should be what? 9, I'd be what?
8.
And this one should be 4.
8 and 4.
All right. Let's get done. And remember that there's a space here. There's a space here and there's another space here. So we are not going to use container fluid in this case. We are going to use container, right? So now, immediately after the nav, look at where my cursor is. After the nav, the closing nav, this is where it is. You create a div. And this div, you give it a class of container. That container means we want it to have space, just like this one here. We want it to have the space here. So, remember what I told you. I told you that for everything that sits side by side, they must be contained inside a row. So you create another div and call it, give it a class called row. Are you guys seeing my screen? Are we good?
Yeah.
All right. So now, this is where we now create our two divs that are sitting side by side. So the first one is div, and you give it a class of cool md8. And the second one, copy this guy, paste it here. This one should be cool md4. Are we good? Are we good?
Yeah. Okay.
You see this? You see, it's not hard now. It's very easy. Hello, guys. Only one person is responding. Only Esther is responding. Are we good?
We're good.
We're good.
All right. So now, remain on the wheel. So, so now inside the cool MV8, you create another div. Now, this div, okay, inside this div, you now create a p tag. That p tag, inside the p tag, you type Lauren. You type your normal Lauren, and you get all this text. Are you seeing the structure? You see how my codes are indented? See, you see the way it's coming? See how the divs are indented. The beauty of Bootstrap. So you give this guy, and it's all good. If you're here, say hi.
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 Okay.
Hi.
All right. Now, before this p tag. Write a h1 and type why should I participate. Save it. Now check your browser, please. Save it and check your browser. You check your browser, let me know. Have you checked your browser?
Yes.
Is it working? Have you seen it?
Yes, everything is working fine.
Okay, you're supposed to see something like this. Yeah, you're supposed to see something like this.
This is what's good.
All right. So now, if you notice, you see that.
Because did you just write this thing now?
I use Lorem now. You are not following. I said, do this. Type LOREM and press tab to give you all those texts.
Okay.
Yeah. Are we good?
No, boss. I have a little disgruntledness.
Bros, use small grammar now. Yeah, this big grammar is what to scatter my. Which one is disgruntledness again?
That's my problem with him. He's always speaking big grammar that is confusing himself.
Sorry, my own. Why should I pass?
Please, if you should help me out, how can I? This choke change to slide and it's really giving me problem. Like when I want to type.
What's that?
Just press the insert button on your keyboard, it will come back normal.
I say I don't know your tab is.
Tab now.
Not tab.
Tab is added.
There's no tab on my this thing. That arrow this thing doesn't have tab on it.
Just look, the key above your caps lock is tab. Any key that is above your caps lock key is tab. Can we continue, please?
Yes, we can.
So, who was the person complaining about his H1 or so? What were you saying?
I was talking about my, the H. And the whole Lauren, came by the edge.
By the edge, how? I don't understand.
Instead of where it sat now, like yours.
This thing is easy. Let me do it again so that you guys will see. There's nothing there. Watch. You guys should look. Look my screen now. Look my screen. Look my screen. Just calm down and look my screen. I first did H1 and I closed it. Inside this H1, I type why should I.
Boss, making the spacing work.
Now look at again. I pressed enter and I did this P tag here. Came inside this way. You understand?
Yes.
And I now type Lorem. And I pressed tab. What else are you confused about? Is your own not working now?
Yes.
Yeah?
The own they work. What is complaining that his own. It's not aligned the way yours is.
If you align it now, please, let's continue. So if you have checked it, if the whole thing is working fine, now what I want you to do, you see this div here, this div that is here, the div that is wrapping the H1 and the P tag. You see where my cursor is?
Yes.
Give it a class. Let the name of the class be Jumbotron. Jumbotron. Save it and check your browser. You see the magic. Mr. Francis, you see that all those things you did with just this class, you would have achieved that. But I knew you use CSS.
Okay, it has changed the background.
Have you seen it? That's what that Jumbotron did. And it will automatically space the whole thing for you. You see, it has already given it space. Okay. Yeah. Now, if you
I said I checked online for videos, but I got lost with the code they were using. That's
the problem. If somebody have not guided you, except you're very, very smart and good before you watch a video and follow up, because the video will just be doing the stuff and you won't even understand. When I was telling you, I actually used the video to build the website. But if you tell me build the website again without the video, I won't know what I'm doing. So that's just it. So now, if you notice, you see that this Jumbotron is touching the nav.
Yes.
But in ours, it wasn't touching the nav. Are you seeing it?
Yes.
So what you just do, immediately after this nav bar, you see immediately after this nav bar here, put a break tag there. Just say this B arrow and close it. It will keep a space there for you. Yeah, it has already done that. Are we good? Are we good?
Yes.
Who called me? Are you lost? Let's find you. Okay, no answer. Let's continue. So now, if you look at our why do you participate here, the color is what?
Blue.
All right. How many of you remember how to get this color?
Secondary.
Eh?
Secondary.
Go and give it now. Give it the
color. Secondary.
You give it a class and give it a color. So give it the color. If it gives you blue, you know you've gotten it. If it didn't give you blue, you know that you failed it. So you keep changing all of them till you get this blue, this particular blue. We have two types of blue. So till you get this particular blue. If you have gotten it, say hi.
Wow.
Have you gotten it? Hello? Some of you have gotten it. Oh, you guys learn to forget. Oh, man.
Let's go back to your code page.
I said, this why do you participate? We want the color to be blue. So I've taught you guys how to make colors, to give colors in Bootstrap, with Bootstrap class. So make this guy, give it a blue color. Not using style, using a class. I showed you guys yesterday. So if you didn't watch the video, you didn't practice. How many of you remember how we got this red color?
I remember, sir.
The same thing we did in getting this red color. That's what you do to get this blue color. So you can check your code. Today I can waste time. As if you guys want us to waste time, I'll waste time. I don't have any pleasure on me today, so. Who has gotten it?
I'm typing, sir.
Since yesterday, you have been typing.
My fault now.
It's just a class now. Just give it class. Bam, bam, bam. Everything is done.
Yes. Class, text center, text.
I didn't say give it text center or don't give it text center. Text center is the center. It just give it only color.
Okay, sir. Text secondary.
Done.
Check it now whether it's blue.
Yeah, done. It's blue.
It's blue.
Yes.
Yes.
But I don't think it's blue.
Secondary will not give you blue. Secondary,
it's info now. Text info.
Text info is blue. That's correct.
It's not blue. Not blue.
Yeah, people don't get that text.
All right, we are good. Can we continue?
Yes,
we can continue.
Done.
All right, so let's continue.
Hello, boss. I'm still having issues. My nav bar is not filling up. Just how? Like your own.
It's not filling up like this.
Yeah, yes. If you I must, make it mobile.
You must have made a mistake somewhere now because it's the same code. You saw the way I copied it now. I copied it. I didn't change anything. You must have made a slight mistake. So what you just do, just watch the video. That you too, you make videos now. Just go through that video. You see the error. Just take your time.
Because my own they work well.
For the first time I found this.
Go back to your.
So now we are inside this other guy. We want to move over to this other guy now. The Cole MB4. So first thing we are going to do, we need that image. Let me see. Yeah, we need this image now. Okay. So we'll first of all, we'll call the image. I taught you guys how to call image. IMG. Let me look for the name of the image.
The image is string.
Okay.
3.png.
So you say IMG slash
3.png.
Save it and check your browser. Check your browser, something will happen. What happened? Tell me fast.
Image occupied everywhere.
It's too big.
Yes.
All right. So there's something we did yesterday to make the image fit in. Who remembered? We did something yesterday to make the image contain, to make the image fit in the size of the container that is holding it. Who remembered? You guys should be answering me now so that now I'm teaching people.
Please, can somebody help me? If I press on my
screen, yeah.
Things get deleted.
Image fluid.
You say if you press on what?
Image fluid. My space bar, the stuff I type will delete.
Space bar or tab?
So.
If you press on space bar, what you type will delete.
I told you my stroke arrow, like where I click, it changed to a dash, like.
Okay, your stroke arrow changed to a dash. Look for where the root insert on your keyboard. Just press insert again, it will come back. Look for a key called insert on your keyboard. Press it again, it will come back to that slash.
Okay.
Has it come back?
I think they look for insert.
Every laptop keyboard has insert now.
And it's boldly written.
Insert. Look for F12. Beside F12 or so. Have you seen it?
Okay, yeah.
Look at how I'm here telling you what is on your keyboard.
Because now the same.
Has it come back?
Yeah, it has. Thank God.
It's not the same. It's not like it's the same keyboard. Every keyboard, like keyboard, has an order now. So once you know your keyboard order, you know how it is. Like when she was saying this, when she was saying there's no tab on her system. Tab is always
a tab. I have a tab, but just
an arrow.
Yes.
They didn't write tab.
But it doesn't do what you say.
Okay, no problem. All right, let's continue. So you see now you've delayed us, and what I just did now you didn't follow. Look at this place. Have you copied this thing on your screen?
I'm sorry.
Mm. No, I don't battle this thing today.
What?
So if you have used the image fluid, have you checked it on your browser? Is it working?
Yes. It has gone to the normal position.
All right. Now one more thing. If you look at the design we are looking, you see that there's something like a border around the image. Have you seen it?
Yes.
Have you seen that round border? It's only one person that is answering me. Why?
We are here.
Yes, I'm typing.
Have you seen this border around the image?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. All
right. So we need to add that. So to get that border around the image, inside that place where you did image flu, just add IMG thumbnail. It will give it that border. IMG thumbnail. It should give it that border. It's been long I used that stuff for. I don't know if it's still correct. Okay, 12, yeah. So look at my screen, fix it. You see IMG fluid space IMG thumbnail. Mr. Francis, are you still with us?
Okay, the border is white.
Mr. Francis, are you still with us?
Yes, I'm here.
You are not saying anything. I thought maybe you're off.
No, I'm here.
Are you following us at all? Are you lost?
I'm just trying to fix my nerve. That thing is not giving me what.
Don't worry. Let's continue. You can fix the nerve later now. You want to miss this part?
No, I'm not missing it. I'm following it. Exactly what you're doing, I'm doing.
All right. Are we good? Are we all good?
Yes, we are good.
So we have our image now. So the next thing we want to do is to add this button, right?
Yes.
All right. So let's go back to our code. So now, below the image, type button, BUTTON. Then in between that button, type register. And you put your phone number. Mine is 07036788652. Put your phone number, save it, and check your browser. Have you done that?
Yes.
Is it working?
Yes.
Now, you see that the button is touching the image and we don't want it to touch the image, right?
Yes, we'll put BR.
Yeah, put BR. That's a very smart guy. Put BR. And BR will take it down. If BR didn't take it down, add another one. So I'm using two BRs. Are you seeing it?
Yes, sir.
So use two BR to take it down. Are we good?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you notice, you see that our own button.
It's not red.
You see that our button is red, but this one is not red. So we want it to be red. So what you now do, give the button a class. If you guys notice, you see that we have not written any CSS. We are just using classes. That's how Bootstrap is. That's how I was able to build that website today. They called me around 5 a.m. to start working on that site, but I didn't wait. I woke around 7, started it, and I'm done with it. So you give it a class, BTN space BTN danger. That's, first of all, you're telling Bootstrap that this is a button. That's the meaning of the first BTN. Then the BTN danger means the color of the button. Check it out and see. Check it in your browser. Let's know if it's red. Have you checked it?
Yes, sir, it's ready.
Yeah.
Everywhere that is you.
Now, everywhere is looking nice, right?
Yes, sir.
So that means if you want to get blue, you will use BTN what?
Info.
Very correct. And if you want to get green, you use BTN what?
Secondary.
Success.
Very good. Very good. If you want to get gray, use BTN what?
Second.
Very good. Very good. If you want to get yellow, use BTN what? If you want to get yellow, use BTN what?
Primary.
Yeah? Yellow is BTN what?
Warning.
All right. Warning. If you want to get white, you use BTN what? None of you will get it. I didn't teach you that one. Use BTN light, you get white. So now
black is dark.
Now, if you notice, this one, the button filled the whole space, but this other one, the button is just here, right?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
So to get that, come back here and say BTN-block. Save it and check your browser. Hello, Mr. Francis. Hello.
I'm with you, sir.
Are you seeing that the stress you did yesterday, the stress you went through yesterday, you wouldn't have gone through?
I'm telling you, I use CSS for everything.
I know.
I use Diva to style it.
I know, don't worry. So you check it out, you see that the whole thing is blocked now. Are we good?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good.
All right. So the next thing now, we want to get this guy to be scrolling. And if you look, there's a line up and there's a line down, right?
Yes.
Now, to get that line in Bootstrap, it's called horizontal line. To get that line, use what we call HR tag. Look at it, HR. Just like the BR. One HR is one line. My time is running out. The second HR is another line. So in between the two HRs, you now put a P tag there and say, you can't afford to miss our Bootstrap make the Bootstrap the B to be capital B. Save it, check your browser. See what I did? The first one HR at the top, one HR at the down. In between the two HR, you put your P tag and do this guy. Check your browser and let's see. Have you checked your browser?
So we are still typing.
This thing that didn't take me like 1 second.
Working now, working.
It's working, right?
Yes, please.
All right. Mine is not working though. Okay, it's working. All right. So now, come back here. Make it bold. Because if you notice, the guy is bold. Make it bold. Then, give it a class of text-info so that it will be blue. Then, wrap the whole guy with Makwi. Mark with that so that it will be scrolling. I've taught you guys Makwi before now. You guys have seen Makwi before. So wrap it with Makwi and it will be scrolling. You saw what I did, Abby? Is there anybody that didn't see what I did?
We did.
Okay. So the P, you give it a class of text info, put a wrap the text with bold tag, then inside you wrap it with Makwi. Check your browser again, it should be wrote now. If you have done it, say hi, let me know. I'm with people.
Hi,
okay, that's cool.
Hi,
that's cool.
Hi,
hi,
wow, we are good. So let me check, and we are good. So you see, Bootstrap is very easy and sweet. We are getting the website.
I tell you most solemnly.
We are getting a website like this. So now the next page, you guys can actually complete the website now. Right? There's nothing there again. So, now, this part, this meets the instructors. It will enter another row and another div, and it will collect code 12 because it's taking the full length. And this guy here, this arrow here, is just a normal guy, just the normal guy there. So, let's continue. Below this guy, create another div. You see, anytime you want to start a new stuff, we always create another D. Sorry. Always make sure you're okay. We are still in this row. Now let's leave this row. We don't want to work with this row again. We want to work with a separate row. So we are going out of that row. Please trace your code very well. If not, you make mistake. We are going.
Which one did we got?
See.
Okay.
Look at here.
Okay.
Look at body. Look at this div. So I'm here. Div. I'm creating another row class. Row. So inside this place, you now create another div and give it the class of cool and the 12. That's full length. And inside, you create H2 and say meet the instructors. What am I typing? Meet the instructors. Now, this meet the instructors, we want it to be centered on the page, so we give it a class of text center. So if you have done this, check your browser, you should be good. Let me highlight what we did just now so that you'll be fast.
Okay.
Are we good?
Yeah, we are.
Okay. Who else? Any other person? Confirm, please. Let's continue.
You are good.
All right. So now we want to give it another line. So we give it HR. Because if you see our design, we have a small HR here, so give it HR2, save it, and check again. Are we good?
Yeah.
All right. So below, go below this div. You see this div that has cool MD12, go outside it. Or let's go outside this row. Go out of this row. You guys are seeing my screen. Create another div and give it a class of row again. And inside this one, now let me ask you a question. How many guys do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Each of them will be called what?
3.
Very correct. So div, say class of cool MD3. Copy it and paste it 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Save it. I have 2 minutes to go before I create another link. We are definitely going to finish this web page today. Are we good?
We are. You should paste it how many times? 1, 2.
You should paste it 3 times with the first one you created to be 4.
Yes, we are good.
Who else? Pamela, are you with us?
Yes. I am.
Leonard, are you with us?
I've been on network.
Leo, are you with us?
Yeah, I'm here.
Elsie, are you with us?
Yes, I'm here.
All right, let's continue. So now, look at this guy. If you see that there's a little round border around this guy. So let's continue. You create a div inside this guy and say, okay, create a div. And oh, this is what I should have just done. Hello guys, look at my screen. I think I should just finish with one and paste it. So let me remove all these other guys. So let's finish with one.
Before we paste.
Yeah. So create this guy and give it a class of card.